Hey guys, I'm Iliza Shlesinger.
And I'm Margaret Cho.
And this is, I feel like it should be like the whole audience says, ask a comedian. There's nobody here. And this is the part of the show, not our show, where we take questions from Netflix fans and we took out all the ones about feet. And that leaves us about two questions.
I try to like make sure that all of my vertebrae are straight. So I try to like do like bend and then come stand back up so that all of my vertebrae is like one line. I just want to be like upright and straight, and then I want to like make sure that I remember all of what I'm supposed to do.
Yeah.
That's all.
You don't be a scoliosis comic.
The audience, I think they always sort of like manually assess you with their eyes.
Yeah.
They do a scan and sort of see what you're about.
Yeah.
It's like a back erection.
You want a back erection.
Yeah.
I don't remember, but I have been auditioning for so long, which is part of why I wrote my own movie, because I was like, I'm not booking anything. I auditioned for The Hangover. That's how long I've been auditioning. I was never gonna get that, and I auditioned for Community.
Wow.
That's a while. That's a lot of no's.
I auditioned for Jurassic Park, the first Jurassic Park. Before we even had a script, they would just give you the Michael Crichton novel, and then just go give you a page and go, just read that. Just
imitate your favorite dinosaur.
Just read that page, yeah.
There it is. Nice, guys. Way to keep it cool and clean. Way to keep it not weird.
Yes, of course. Because sometimes you're up there for a long time. But then for some reason, I haven't actually gone, maybe like close though. Dangerously close.
To peeing?
Pooing.
Really?
Dangerously close.
Really?
But, you know, I was strong. I lived to tell.
Must be that strong back.
Like, because I was so erect, I was able to like keep it all tight. I do have tattoos. My favorite are the ones on my knees, which are really stupid. It's George Washington and Abraham Lincoln, and it's because it costs $6 to spread them. So dumb.
But like, at least no one can say you're not committed to a bit. Offensive. I think it's unnecessary. I know that Elder Millennial, the eponymously titled Netflix special I did, but also the name for all people my age who were born 1983 or a couple years later, I think Elder Millennial perfectly sums it up. We didn't need a new label. I think everybody's offended by it and it's unnecessary. And the less we say it, Netflix, the less oxygen we give it and hopefully it will die.
Yeah.
Geriatric. Where's my AARP subscription? Where's my free hip? Huh? People are gonna believe it. Like, I think when people think bombing, they think like, tomatoes, you suck. I've never had that. I definitely had violent shows. And this is like way in my youth before we started using the term geriatric to describe my generation. But I've had shows where I've dumped fries on someone. I've dumped a drink on someone.
Wow.
You're like a 27-year-old girl playing like a random club in a parking garage. And some guy's in the front just like talking her on his phone. And like, I just snapped. I think I dumped something on the guy. All of a sudden, out of nowhere, I see a guy just charge across stage, and he was like an off-duty fireman, and he just started a fight with that guy. And like, my dad was there, and I don't remember him charging the stage.
I would like to perform in one of the base camps of Everest, or one of like base camps going towards the Himalayas for climbing, Mount Kailash in like Tibet, or any of these places
right.
that have like base stations, because it's like an international audience, which primarily speak English, of adventurers.
Hmm.
So I like that idea.
You didn't have that answer prepared before this interview?
I did not.
Can I have, I'll use your answer.
Okay.
Okay, here's one. It's not a heckler, but it was a club. A woman in the front row was crying for my entire set. Like, she didn't, maybe didn't start crying, but at least 45 minutes sobbing. And her husband didn't take her out of the room or anything. And it's just very hard to like tell these jokes. And there's just someone quietly sobbing. And then after the show, they were so drunk and the woman like kicked over a sandwich board outside the venue and they got arrested.
Ooh.
But they had flown there for the show. Like, so many mixed emotions.
Comedy brings out the weirdest people.
Well, yeah, it's a lot. It's a night out and there's alcohol or drugs or whatever. Yeah, drugs are kind of a funny one, especially if you do like a rock festival, because people are so high, you're like, what's happening? Like, this one girl like did glow sticks for my whole set, but she was also passed out, but her hands were awake with the glow sticks. And it was like, and when I would tell jokes, she would really do the glow sticks fast. Like,
so she was
laughing.
Hearing it.
She was She could hear it. She would be like, but she, it was very strange.
It's this thing about the anonymity and the darkness and the alcohol.
We see you.
Yeah.
We see you.
We see you. Well, thank you for watching Ask a Comedian. Thank you for joining me, Margaret Cho.
Thank you.
Now that you know all of our secrets as comedians, please watch Good on Paper, out on Netflix, June 23rd.